Hello everyone, welcome to JDK Masterclass. Guys, in today's video, we are going to discuss about frontier molecular orbitals, HOMO and LUMO, which we are going to discuss under pericyclic reaction. You might have heard about FMO approach, PMO approach, Woodward-Hoffman rule to solve the pericyclic reaction. So here, in this particular video, I'll be discussing on HOMO and LUMO on demand, and the topic is very important for MSc Chemistry, BSc Chemistry, CSA NET and GATE examination and other very important competitive examinations. So we'll discuss about it. Frontier molecular orbitals, the short form is FMO. So basically the two pi molecular orbitals are very important to understand the pericyclic reaction. What are those? First is the HOMO, which is called the highest occupied molecular orbital. So the highest occupied molecular orbital will be having the highest energy, and the other is called LUMO, which is called lowest unoccupied molecular orbital having the lowest energy. So we will understand it by taking the ethylene as an example. As we know, ethylene is having only one pi bond, and each pi bond is consist of two electrons. So basically two pi electrons will be there, and we will see that how these are going to form the bond. So this is the energy profile for ethylene. Two pi bonds are there. One is, you can see the ground state. First we draw in a way where the colored lobes are on the same side. Okay, you might have the positive and negative to differentiate it. So in that case, we will say that all the positive lobes in the psi 1 wave function will be on the same side, and the other is negative is on the same side. Okay, so here we have the colored lobes. All the color lobes are on the same side, which will have the lowest energy and highest occupied molecular orbital. You can notice here. And the two pi electrons, as you notice, are occupied in the ground state. Ground state, all the thermal reactions occurs in the ground state. Okay, and all the photochemical reactions occurs in the excited state. This is very important point, which you can note it down, that ground state you can conduct any thermal reaction, and excited state all the photochemical reaction. So, and the other possibility to draw for the energy, the little high energy, is one positive lobe is above the plane, the other is on the below the plane. So you have basically plus and minus are on the one same side, and so it generates a node here. Whenever you have opposite color or opposite side on the same side, then it generates a node here. So basically the ground one, all positive are on the same side, which will form molecular orbital, and there is no node, and therefore you can say for psi 1 there is zero node. And as you increase in the energy, the node will increase in the same sequence, like 0, 1, 2 and so on. So for psi 2 you have only one node between the two orbitals, so one node. And if you place a mirror plane here in between this two lobe, then you can say it is symmetrical. And therefore, for psi 1, it is symmetrical with respect to the mirror plane. And C2 is axis of symmetry, means 180 degree you have to rotate, and then all the symmetrical orbitals will become asymmetrical orbitals. So you can write S for mirror plane, and A will be antisymmetrical for C2 plane. So that means you have just rotated this orbital 180 degree. Now the non-color will be above the plane and color will be below the plane. It will be same like psi 2 in the ground state, and so it will give you the asymmetrical. If you place a mirror here, you can notice you don't have symmetry, and so psi 2 is asymmetrical. So you can notice here it is asymmetrical, and after rotating it 180 degree, the color lobe will go on the above the plane and it will be symmetrical. So basically for ethylene, you have two orbitals, two wave functions, psi 1 and psi 2, with 0 and 1 node respectively, and the symmetries are also mentioned. Now HOMO and LUMO, you can notice that two electrons will be occupied in the lowest energy orbital. So since the ethylene is having two electrons, it will be occupied in the lowest orbital, and the above is unoccupied one. So for ground state you have HOMO, the highest occupied will be psi 1 and lowest unoccupied will be psi 2. So HOMO and LUMO for ground state, or the thermal reaction will be psi 1 and psi 2 respectively. While for photochemical reaction, which occurs from the excited state, one of the electron from the psi 1 will transit to the psi 2, and now the HOMO in the excited state, that is the highest occupied, will be the psi 2, and LUMO also will be the psi 2 for this if you conduct the HOMO-LUMO reaction for ethylene under photochemical condition. Let's take another example, 1,3-butadiene. You can see this is the structure, and here you have 2 pi electrons. Each pi electron, the 2 pi bonds, each pi bond is having 2 electrons, so total 4 electrons are there. 4 orbital stages are possible here. Okay, wave function psi 1, psi 2, psi 3, psi 4. 4 arrangements are possible. So starting from 4 pi electrons, 4 pi lobes we have arranged, and as we know that all the color lobes will be on the same side in psi 1, means all positive on the same side, will form a molecular orbital, okay, and with zero node, you don't have any node here, so psi 1, and then the number of nodes will increase from 0 to 1 in psi 2. So we have to arrange in a way that if you place a node here, means a colored and non-colored lobe, okay, on the, and you place a mirror here, so this is one node, plus minus creates a node here. Okay, so one node will be there, because between color there is no node, non-color there is no node. So between plus and minus, or colored and non-colored, there is a node. So node is here one. As you go for psi 3, we have to arrange the orbitals in a way that the node will be, node should be 2. So how we can create 2? When you have plus minus or color non-color here, one node. Minus minus or non-color, there is no node, and then again one node here, okay, between color and non-color. So two nodes are there, and then again for psi 4, three nodes should be there. How? Alternative arrangement of the orbital will give you three nodes. One here, the other here, and the third one is here. Okay, so 0, 1, 2, three nodes, and total four electrons are there. Two will occupy in psi 1 and two will occupy into psi 2. So maximum 2 electrons can be occupied, and so the highest occupied orbital for ground state, transition state, will be psi 2 under for the thermal reaction, and lowest unoccupied is psi 3. So HOMO is psi 2 and LUMO is psi 3 for thermal reactions which occurs in the ground state, while photochemical reactions will occur in the excited state, and the highest occupied psi 2, one electron will move to the next orbital, that is psi 3. So now the highest occupied orbital will be psi 3 under photochemical reaction. Okay, now psi 3 is the HOMO, and lowest unoccupied will be psi 4 for photochemical reaction. So you have changed, you can see here, there is a change in the HOMO and LUMO when you conduct the reaction in the thermal or photochemical conditions. So same thing you can notice here in this diagram, where we have 2, pi 1 and pi 2, or psi 1 and psi 2 will act as a bonding orbitals, and that the other 2 is called antibonding orbitals. You can notice here, and the wave functions are denoted here with the number of nodes, their respective symmetries. In the same way, you place a mirror here, it is symmetrical. Then asymmetrical, again you place a mirror here in the center, symmetrical, and then asymmetrical here. Okay, if you place a mirror, it is asymmetrical. Again, if you rotate 180 degree on the one side, it will become alternative. So if you write S here, it is A in C2. Okay, opposite symmetries. You can notice here bonding orbital and antibonding molecule. So this is the MOT of 1,3-butadiene and HOMO-LUMO of 1,3-butadiene. Under thermal and photochemical condition, or you can say the problems you are going to solve using FMO approach. Okay, so 1,3,5-hexatriene also we will see quickly. There are 3 pi bonds, you will be having 3 bonding orbital and 3 antibonding orbitals. In the same way, arrange the node from 0 to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 order. There are total 6 pi electrons, 2 will occupy in each. In the ground state, the HOMO will be psi 3 and LUMO will be psi 4. Excited state, the upper, psi 3, the highest occupied in thermal, the one electron will transit to the next orbital, that is psi 4. So in excited state, the HOMO is psi 4 and LUMO is psi 5. For the excited state means under photochemical condition. Therefore, you will get the different stereochemistry, different product under photochemical and thermal condition. Okay, so this is the MOT of 1,3,5-hexatriene. You can see the number of nodes as the wave function increases, number of nodes increasing. Mirror plane, you can notice the symmetry, and for C2 also it is just alternative symmetry. And finally, we will notice the allylic system. Okay, it can be allylic cation, allylic anion, or allylic free radical. For allylic cation, you have 2 electrons, allylic anion, 4 electrons, and allylic free radical, we will notice here, 3 radicals. Okay, 3 electrons. You can notice, this is 1, 2, 3, 3 carbon center are there, and you have psi 1, psi 2, psi 3. For allylic cation, 2 electrons, so HOMO will be psi 1. LUMO will be psi 2. Number of nodes for psi 1 there is 0, all will form a bonding orbital. For psi 2, if you place a node here, center means it should be opposite sign plus minus. A node will appear here, one node. And here for psi 3, 2 nodes should be there. You can notice one is color in between non-color. And here again, you will have a node. That means this should be non-color and the other should be colored here. Okay. So, 2 nodes should be 0, 1, 2 node. For allylic cation, HOMO is psi 1, LUMO is psi 2. Allylic cation, total 4 electrons. So, psi 1 will occupy 2, psi 2 will occupy 2, and psi 2 will be the HOMO, and psi 3 will be LUMO. And finally, for allylic free radical, the psi 2 will be HOMO with 1 electron, and psi 3 will be LUMO. So, this is for the allylic system. And I hope you understood the HOMO-LUMO concept under FMO approach for pericyclic reaction. If you have any doubts, you can write in the comment section. I will try to explain it in a better way. Happy learning!